So students, be ready to write two more exams to be conducted by ICAI. What? Are we not writing so many exams, so many difficult exams? What is the need to give two more examinations? So institute yesterday came up with an announcement which said that after every year of completion of articleship, you have to complete an assessment exam, which will be a multiple choice question. Let us look at what are the details and why does the institute want to conduct such kind of examination when we are already writing so many examinations. So what is this exam all about? Why do we need one more exam? So the idea, looking at the notification, the idea of the institute looks like they want to actually test what have you learnt in your articleship. Because institute has come across many cases where students do dummy articleship, they want to test the articleship students after every year of articleship. So you will have two exams, one after completion of first year, second after completion of second year. And this will not be written exam, so don't worry about it. This will be multiple choice question based exam. Now when an exam is conducted, what will happen if I pass or fail? So students, don't worry, institute has not brought up a pass or a fail examination. They have actually brought in a grading system. How does the grading system work? If you score 80% or more, you will get A grade. If you score 60% or more, but less than 80%, what you'll get is B grade. Similarly, if you score 40% or more, but less than 60%, you will get C grade. And if you score less than 40%, you will score a D grade. So there is nothing called a passing or a failing in this examination. What you will be getting is a grade. Now, where will this grade be appearing? This grade, all the grades, whatever you score, it will appear in your final mark sheet. So don't think that because there is nothing called a failure, I don't need to take this seriously. You must take this seriously because whatever the grades you have scored, it will appear in the final mark sheet. Now, what if you score, let us say, a grade C or a grade D or a grade B and you want to improve the grades? Is it possible? The institute says you can take the exam two more times by paying a nominal fee and whichever is the highest grade. So if you have taken, let us say, three examinations and in the second exam you got the highest grade, that is the grade that will be printed in the mark sheet. So institute is giving you a flexibility. So will this be useful? Definitely, because when this appears on the final mark sheet, when the employer looks at your mark sheet, he'll figure out that, okay, during the articleship training you might have scored a B or an A or a D. So whatever the grades are there, they are very much relevant when you go and apply for a job. So when do you have to take this exam? The first exam is after completion of your first year of articleship. The second exam is after completion of your second year of articleship. Now, after completion of first year of articleship, what will be tested? You will be tested on accounting, auditing, including law. So this will be tested for 50 marks. And there are three options given to you. You have to choose one option. What are the three options? Direct taxation, indirect taxation, and internal audit. Out of these three, you have to choose any one, and that one subject will account for 25 marks. So 50 plus 25 makes it 75 marks. So after completion of first year of exam, you have to give exam for 75 marks, and this 75 marks exam will be conducted in 2 hours, and it will be a MCQ based exam. So it's not a written exam, it's a simple MCQ based exam. The institute is trying to test, okay, how much you know in accounting, how much you know in auditing, and if you are doing, let's say, direct taxation, how much do you know in direct taxation? And friends, if you look at the modules or the mock papers what they have given, they are largely practical application based. So for example, which ITR form should be filed or which GSTR form should be filed? What is the interest applicable under 234A, B or C? These are the things which you will actually do on your day-to-day articleship. So that is what the institute is trying to test here. In the second year, you will still have accounting, auditing and law for 50 marks. That is already there. Out of the three optional subjects, you have to choose any two, and there is a small change here. With DET, you will also be tested on international taxation. So 50 marks from accounting, auditing and law, and any two optional subjects out of the three, which makes it again 50 marks. The total exam will be for 100 marks and you have to complete it in 3 hours of time. Again, this will also be a MCQ based examination. So the overall structure is actually to test your practical experience. If you look at the questions given at the link, you will find that by and large they are practical practical application. What to do in an audit when a certain situation arises. What to do in taxation when certain situation arises. All these things is what will be tested. So what happens if you are in the third year of the articleship? If you are in the third year of the articleship, you don't need to write this. This is only about who would be completing either first year or second year of articleship. So if you are in the third year of articleship, you don't have to take this exam. If you have already completed first year of articleship and now you are into second year of articleship, then you will have to take only the second exam, which is for 100 marks. So very simple. If you are in first year of articleship, you will have to take two exams. If you are in second year of articleship, you will have to take one exam. And if you are already into third year of articleship, you don't have to take any more exams. Now, when do we take these exams? It's given that after every year of completion. But how to count the dates or how to count what should be the period in which you should take the examination? Institute has divided this, the entire calendar year, into four quarters. You have one quarter, two quarter, three quarter and four quarters. So this will be your Jan to March, April to June, July to September and October to December. If you are completing your articleship in this quarter, you can take the examination in this quarter. If your articleship is completed in this quarter, you can take the examination in this quarter. So if first year is completed in April to June, you write the exam in July to September. If the first year is completed in July to September, you write it in October, December. So this is how the cycle will continue. For the first time, if you have completed the first year or second year of articleship in this quarter, you can write from August to December 2018. So April to June 2018, can write it in August to December 2018. But for July to September 2018, you have to write in October to December 2018. Now this quarterly sequence will follow. And if you are not happy with your grades, you can reattempt the exam. You can reattempt the exam twice by paying a nominal fee and the highest of the grades will be taken. So friends, this exam will be important because the grades will be reflected in your final mark sheet. It will also give you an assessment of how much have you learned in your articleship days. So take this exam seriously. And those of you who are not doing dummy articleship, you need not worry. I have seen the kind of questions. With a proper articleship training, you will be easily able to attempt those questions and pass with grades of A and B. All the best friends, do share this video with your friends. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop it in the comment section. Thank you.